We had started with the sample question paper solutions for the session 2021-22, term 1. As we all know, term 1 will contain only one markers, that is MCQs, not just one markers, I was wrong to say, because the marks are 35 and the questions are 45. So one question, each question will carry 0.78 marks. A little complicated, but we have already covered it in the next video, last video. So hey, welcome everybody to the second part where we'll be doing from 13th MCQ in the sample question paper given by the CBSC. So before we begin with the 13th question, if you have not subscribed to my channel, just subscribe it and don't forget to press the notification bell so that all my videos reach you as soon as they're published. Okay, so without much ado, let me just start with question number 13. Question number 13 is, after surgery of stomach, just remember that whenever you get MCQs, you have to read and concentrate on each and every word. Surgery of stomach, it is given of stomach, of your grandfather who is unconscious, which mode of feeding would be preferred for him? If he is unconscious, oral feeding is not possible. B is tube feeding and C is intravenous. Tube feeding, it's the surgery of stomach. So what you actually have to do is give rest to the stomach. So you won't be giving anything that is easy just to digest, but you want him to get food just for nourishment. Nasogastric feeding, no, it's only a case after operation. He might recover fast. And so the right options comes out to be C, intravenous feeding to get nourishment. You remember intravenous feeding? When it's for a small time, you can give intravenous feeding. Tube feeding is given only when the time when a person is, like, for example, in coma or has an accident where he can't chew. So in that case, tube feeding. Just for a few days, intravenous is perfectly fine. Now we come over to the 14th question. In which year the first SOS village was set up in India and who were the beneficiaries? The year, this you have to remember. You have to memorize it. And I'm sure you will have to do it. There's no other option. But you can make an intelligent guess. If you are confused about how to make a guess, then I'll give you this video link and you can just go and watch how to make an intelligent guess. But remember, guesses are only when you are caught in a big trouble. Otherwise, there is no substitute for hard work. So the year is a bit confusing, but you can surely choose the beneficiaries. So 1954 and disabled children, no, SOS was not just for disabled children. 1964 and abandoned children, yes, it was for abandoned children. This can be an answer. Special needs children, no, not specially. And juvenile delinquents, no, surely not. So you are left with one answer when you look after the beneficiaries. So the right answer is B, 1964 and the abandoned children. The beneficiaries were abandoned children. If you remember, SOS village, it gives a mother to the abandoned child. It gives it a family. So it is for the abandoned child. Now we come over to the 15th question. This is very simple. Sun drying is the oldest method of food preservation. We all know, we have been using it at home also. Which principle of food preservation is involved in it? We have to identify the principle. So what is the principle? If it is sun drying, whether it is lowering of temperature, reduction of pH, removal of water and controlling the availability of oxygen, it's not airtight, so not availability of oxygen. Temperature can be lowered, yes. Reduction of pH, no. pH ke liye to you make use of lemon, vinegar. But lowering of temperature, it's basically by cooking. By sun drying, you don't actually lower the temperature too much. And also it is drying. Drying means removal of water. So very simply, the option is C, that is removal of water. So this one was pretty simple. I'm sure all of you will be able to attempt it. Now I'll come over to question number 16. Which of the following is not a feature of good manufacturing practices, that is GMP? So here we are talking about which is not. So if it is not, you have to look out for negative. Minimize false labeling. Obviously, this is part of GMP. Consumer protection, this is also a part of GMP. Eliminate contamination, this is the whole objective of GMP. Now, mislead consumer, obviously not. GMP or any other practice obviously does not lead to the misleading of the consumer. So this is also pretty clear. Fourth option, that is D, mislead consumer. Now the 17th question, you have to identify who is the person who is the chairperson and managing director of Biocon India Limited. I am sure many of you, by just this company's name, Biocon India Limited, must have identified the lady. She's very famous and very dynamic. She is one of the greatest entrepreneurs. She started her career as a trainee brewer in Carlson and United Beverages. In 2005, she was honored with Padma Bhushan. Identify the personality. Do I need to give the options? The answer is very clear. It's A, Ms. Kiran Mazumdar Shaw. Just remember, if you get confused, read all the options. It's quite possible that Kusum Mazumdar Shaw is the first answer, and in a hurry you just click on Kusum Mazumdar Shaw or Kiran Mazumdar Shah. You might click on this if you are in a hurry and don't read all the questions thoroughly. This overconfidence can also make you down. So Miss Kiran Mazumdar Shaw. 17th is also over. Next, I'll move over to the 18th question. 18th question is, your sister has completed her diploma in clinical nutrition and dietetics. So choose from the following options which are available to her to start her new career. It is nutrition and dietetics. So school council or no. For that you need to do ECC. Research and development of nutraceuticals. Yes, this is a very important part of clinical nutrition. ECC ke baad you become a school counselor in agriculture industry. Yes, she can also work in agriculture industry, but not that much. The agricultural products are researched by clinical nutritionists and dietetics, and basically they can conduct a study in nutraceuticals. The answer is B, research and development of nutraceuticals. Now we move over to the 19th question. Which of the following act as biological catalyst to accelerate chemical reactions? You have to go through biological catalyst and they need to accelerate the chemical reactions in food. Pesticides? No. Do they accelerate chemical reactions? Exposure to light? Light is not a biological catalyst. Enzymes? Yes, this is biological also. And catalyst also. So I think C is the right answer. Moisture is not a catalyst at all. So C is the right answer. Enzymes are the biological catalyst which accelerate the chemical reaction in food, and it may lead to the spoilage in food. 20th question, name the agency which set up the guidelines for adoption to safeguard the welfare right of the children. So which is it? Do you remember? Yes, NARA, KARA, KAPA or RAKA. I don't know what all these mean. They are do you know the full forms of all these? Which one can be? It's adoption. So it is KARA, option C. Can you tell me the full form of KARA? Give the full form of KARA in the comment box, okay? Or let me tell you, it is the Central Adoption Research Resource Authority. So this is Central Adoption Resource Authority. So it basically gives the guidelines for the adoption. Not everybody can adopt a child out of his free will. After Corona, you might have heard a few cases where the advertisements or publicity was done for few children who were rendered orphans. But not anybody can adopt it. And this is very important, KARA, because you have to frame certain guidelines so that the children are not misused. The child has a proper childhood, taken proper care of. Okay, it will otherwise lead to exploitation of children. Question number 21, which of the following is not an objective of the diet therapy? Which is not an objective of diet therapy? Modification of the diet. This is the main part of diet therapy. You have to make the modification. Knowledge of traditional cuisines. I don't think this is the objective of diet therapy. This is needed, the knowledge is needed, but the knowledge of traditional cuisine is not diet therapy. If you want to become a chef, a professional chef, then you need to have the knowledge of traditional cuisine. Knowledge of traditional cuisine is important, but it is not the objective. Okay, so you need to read the question very thoroughly. Prevention of complications, yes, this is an objective of diet therapy. And correction of nutritional deficiency, this is one of the most important objective of diet therapy. So the answer is C, B, knowledge of traditional cuisines. Question number 22, at which age the child can distinguish between a stranger and familiar people? What is the age? 6 to 8 months? Generally, if you carry a six-month-old child, it will just go out. If you say that I am going outside, it will come to you very fast and say, I want to go out. So 6 to 8 months I don't think is right. 8 to 12 months, 1-year-old child is pretty big and he definitely recognizes strangers and familiar people. So the right answer is B, 8 to 12 months. Now we come to question number 23. In how many minutes can Salmonella bacteria double their number? We have done it in the video also. It's every 20 minutes. How fast they multiply, and this is the reason that the infection spreads really fast. Okay, now shall we move over to the next question? That is question number 24. Question number 24, mention the years in which the national policy for older persons and national youth policy were adopted. A, year 1999 and 2003. Year 98, 2003, 99, 2004, and 1998 and 2004. This is one question where you need to memorize. In case you don't know the answer, if you have forgotten it, just don't attempt the question, leave it as a choice. But I will tell you the answer. It's 1999 and 2003. So national policy for older persons, it was in 1999, and for youth, it was in 2003. Right answer is A. And the last question of section A, question number 25 is, identify the components present, read the question again, components present in natural food or fruit products manufactured wherein specific ingredients have been included to confer health benefits. So medicinal foods, no, medicinal foods, let me take up nutraceuticals, it's possible. Medicinal foods, know where it is written for medical use. Antioxidants, not necessarily. These components could be anything. Phytochemicals is also a possible answer. So B or C, though, we have already eliminated. The choices between nutraceuticals and phytochemicals. If you remember, phytochemicals are basically plant components. So if it was mentioned specially plant chemicals, plant components, then it would be phytochemicals. But here it is given, it could be any natural food or food product, and this ingredient has been included to confer health benefits. If it was medical benefits, it would have been medicinal foods. But health benefits, it has been included. So it will be surely nutraceuticals. So A is the right answer. Don't get confused. But I think that you will get a question from nutraceuticals or phytochemicals. Just read this topic and understand it very thoroughly. In case you have a doubt in any of these questions, you can ask me in the comment box. I'll be very glad to clarify your doubts. Just prepare well, score 100 on 100, and when you are practicing, attempt all the 25 questions. But finally, you have a choice of 5 questions when you attempt the paper. Choose the best options, best questions which you know. Again, best of luck. I'll see you on the other side in the next video, where we'll talk of the questions in section B. Okay, so all the best, keep preparing, and see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.